So here we go with the setting or the exactness of the guitar measurements concerning the playability and its tuning.
Sabes que la guitarra me gusta, me puse a tocar, la puedo amplificar. De repente veo que hay sectores que no. Siento que está como muy alta, no sé yo, muy alta o no me siento muy cómoda de tocar o me trastea un poquito. ¿Cómo la puedo calibrar? ¿En qué consiste la calibración de una guitarra? Empezamos por una española tradicional.
Bien, eso es justamente lo que vos, los problemas que te pueden surgir en una guitarra son temas de calibración, estos que estás mencionando. Y básicamente una guitarra que viene calibrada quiere decir que está la cuerda lo suficientemente pegada para que esté cómoda y que afine. Básicamente esos son los dos tips más importantes de calibrado, es que la guitarra afine y que la guitarra esté cómoda de tocar. A veces, la afinación de una guitarra depende de la construcción de la misma. Hay guitarras que son imposibles de hacer afinar tal cual como están construidas. A veces es simplemente corregir algún apoyo de la secuela en el puente, de la cija de acá.
So he's meaning here that the saddles, when the saddle is, if the saddle is, if the string is resting on this point of the saddle, is different than if it rests on here, right? Because it has some curve here. So then, therefore, sometimes they inaccuracies on the frets. Luthiers try to save face by sanding this in a way that, you know, if you sand this way, then it goes flat and then sharp. If you need sharper tone, then they sand the other way around. So it's like a way to try to compensate defects in the setting, right? When the guitar is perfectly made, as in the case of AG, this never happens. But he's explaining here how this calibration thing of the setting or adjusting the setting to save face because of problems tuning the guitar have generally.
Digamos el traste cero. Entonces hay correcciones que se pueden hacer, que las puede hacer el mismo guitarrista, a veces que puede visitar un luthier y las corrige rápidamente, incluso en el mismo momento. Y hay otras calibraciones que requieren ya un trabajo de reparación. Si sí, vos, un diapasón de una guitarra a veces está dividido en el proceso de fabricación, se serrucha y se colocan los trastes, y esta regla, esta progresión de los trastes, se supone que tiene que estar bien resuelta para el luthier, pero algunas guitarras ya vienen mal de fabricación. Entonces, eso ya es un trabajo mayor y ahí se requeriría levantar los trastes y corregir dónde van colocados.
So what happens is that, and by the way, in Spain, no guitar tunes except AG fretboards. I have this experience because I own every brand you can imagine and name of any guitar in the 35 years I have playing professionally, and I can tell you that no guitar tunes, especially the most famous ones. And you can do a very simple test yourself, not even with a ruler or a high precision digital device or anything, no? Like a caliper or these kind of things. But just with a business card, we can do a test. Let me show you here this thing.
You can do with just a pencil and a business card. Then you draw a line, put the card like this, place the card, and then you draw a line. Exactly.
So you see, this is the first fret here, right? First fret.
The half of the fret, this way.
Like this, you draw a line at the center of the fret, right? By the way, thanks to Maestro Corrias for this great tip, which is an easy way to detect the nonsense luthiers do cynically over and over, because guitars have not proper correspondence of the frets to begin with, and of course then they have to talk about adjusting the saddles, but no, right? Because it's wrong, the division of the fret. yeah, the progression of this division.
As you can observe, the distances here have to be proportionally shorter from right to left, right? Because why? Because the fretboard, when these frets have to be shorter distance, the more we go to this part, right? It has to be from more to less. And this shows here. And then we just go to analyze a normal guitar. Here we will see that there are some inconsistencies in the fret placement, which will, of course, cause issues in tuning, because here the distances are almost not only not proportionately shorter from right to left, but look at this last two lines. That space is big.
Hello, look at this. Big, short, big, short, bigger than the first one. Like, hello. So, here we go.
The second last, from left to right, I mean.
That is a 4,000 euro guitar, don't think it's a cheap one.
One can observe.
In any guitar.
Perfect.
Has to be perfectly installed first.
And consistent.
That's right.
Fretboard division.
This is the new fretboard division. And that also, of course, we need to mention that Mr. Hermann Hauser do have the perfect fretboard, like AG also. He never said anything, was ultra smart. And in fact, here we will talk about one more point, which is the fact that the zero fret, namely this device, will help not only in getting the same tone all over, because the combination is carbon fiber saddle with metal of the frets, right? And therefore this left-hand saddle, wooden left-hand saddle, serves only with the purpose of the division of the strings, which, by the way, Paco liked it pretty short, this, and having a big room on these points. Well, now, the point we are saying is that not only is more accurate the tuning now in AG with this zero fret, and zero fret origin is actually Hermann Hauser who brought this to the classical guitar world. Here we have a guitar from 1934 Hermann Hauser guitar, which has the zero fret here. You can see, right? This is the zero fret. You see? So, this is a Hermann Hauser 1934 guitar. Loving guitar, this one. It has its heart and the head and everything. Very nice. So, it was Hermann Hauser. Look at this beauty. This is like 100 years old, probably. And here is the zero fret as well. So, this is ultra accurate, because Mr. Hauser was more, of course, smarter than any Spanish luthier of that time on and of now, with the exception of these great people in AG and certain skilled people like Arcángel Fernández and these guys. But let's say that Hermann Hauser is very high caliber of luthier. All my respects to this luthier, because this is really a luthier, not a guitarrero, just or not one who knows so-called the oficio, but really a engineer in acoustics and a perfectionist in measurements, etc. So here we have the same kind of fretboard that we the fret division that we have in AG. And therefore, the zero fret here will play a very important role in this tuning thing, because here not only it will get the normal bone, obsolete bone, left hand saddle will be wore off, and then we have problems, Houston, because let me show you here in this other video. We'll post in the description 5 awful inconveniences of everyday guitars, and at the description we can click on the examples here to see one thing. Measurements from the, wait a moment, here we have, yeah, this is the thing. Okay, because of the zero fret thing, here we have, wait a moment.
Here, as you can see,
so this thing here will be, of course, wear off at some point, and then the point where it rests the string, it will be different and affecting the tuning, obviously, and also the tone is death, because the bone of an animal dead is a death sound, that I prove in other videos as well. So, and by the way, because in AG this is the right hand saddle made of carbon fiber, and this one here is an excellent transmission of sound and an excellent way to vibrate the strings. Of course, this is works better after years of experiments in AG. It was discovered that it works better not with rosewood bridge, because this is too hard, but with maple or pau amarelo or other sateen or different woods which have different consistencies, because this is a whole science. This is not just anything. It has to be done with brain, right? And much brain, and with a lot of budget, because these things, who will pay these experiments? No one pays it. The customer doesn't pay it. It has to be these marvelous people of AG that invested all the necessary to get there. And of course, this was, as we said before, implemented by Hermann Hauser back in the 1934, nothing less. Now, because of the fact that the zero fret helps with the tuning and with the tone, it gives accuracy, and this is much more durable, of course, than wood, and it gives the exact point. Also in playability, you have the same exact action that you have in every fret, and your sound will be in any place you play from the first fret combination of metal and carbon fiber. While in the traditional, so-called traditional guitars, the problem is that the sound will be bone with bone, an open string, right? And then bone with metal in every other fret. So that is uneven. This is another disadvantage of the obsolete ways of the tradition regarding this thing. As opposed to the marvelous invention of Mr. Hermann Hauser, which was now implemented in flamenco guitars by AG, which, by the way, this is just it's not accurate, it's what is after that. So it's most accurate tuning, because the division of the frets is perfect, and because of the zero fret, making the playability unbelievable easy to play this thing, and the tone will be even, because we have metal and carbon fiber all of the frets and not just something else in open position. That's why people like to play, in the past we like to play with capo, because it's brighter, put the capo at 1 or 2, or like the Paco had also guitars with the capo permanently on the first fret, because this is a problem with the old left hand saddle, which is obsolete. So now, thanks to God, this was eliminated totally from the face of the earth in AG. And if you have not tried a zero fret guitar, you need to do it, because this is what is perfection in accurate division, fret division, the most accurate and the only one accurate in Spain is this, and the 0 fret, which gives the tone even, the lowest action capacity, which, by the way, action has also been misunderstood as just the measurement from the string to the fret on the 12th fret. That's not action, that is a tourist concept of action. I will explain now what is the whole thing, in other words, what I learned from Paco about this. And yeah, here we go. So you see, this is the thing, right? And therefore, this is most accurate fretboard in the world of the nylon string guitars. So here we go. Then, therefore, let's continue with these arguments.
Hay muchas guitarras que sí, y en otras hay guitarras de fábrica también bien hechas que tienen eso solucionado. También los puentes, a veces voy a exagerar, pero un puente puede estar pegado muy adelante o muy atrás, entonces la distancia proporcional a la relación de confluencia de diapasón es incorrecta.
Okay, so therefore here is he's touching another important point. If this, in fact, I like to make these videos as part of the bridge series, please watch the 2 videos about the bridge, because the bridge is the most important part of the guitar. But now we're talking about the fretboard, the 0 fret, and some things there. But action means only the bridge has to be perfectly settled. So he's right in this point, that if this is wrong, if it's wrongly placed, and wrongly placed means a tenth of a millimeter can be wrong, and then we have problem Houston, because it will not tune well. Now, so this thing here is true. So therefore, see the importance of the bridge. And therefore, I will post at the description, the first 2 videos will be those of the series of the bridge 1 and series of the bridge 2 for you to see.
Las guitarras más habituales son de tiro 65, o tiro aproximado a eso, 65, es el tiro, recordamos, que va del traste 0, de la cejita que se coloca acá, a la secuela del puente, ¿no?
Sí, varía según también el estilo.
You see, bone and bone. Here we go, this is bone and bone. And then frets, metal and bone. So, ugly, really. It's totally obsolete, this thing. This is my opinion, of course. If you want to be brainwashed by the tradition, I have no problem. I said already my disclaimer in the first video of the series, and I challenge any luthier to try to play what I play at the beginning of this video to prove that they know, because no luthier plays one damn thing. They play kindergarten level, so they cannot tell me what is playability. This is my point, and I challenge them again one more time, on the advice of Paco, to put them in their place, which is very low regarding technique, execution of the guitar, and knowledge of playing. And therefore, they have to do what we said, not that they say what they taught us players, what is desiderable or playable. We will tell them what to do. This is what Paco said, and this is what I said. Okay.
Exacto, el tiro más habitual quizás es 65, pero muchas veces, y esto también tiene que ver con la elección de una guitarra para cada uno, si uno tiene una mano extremadamente chica, a veces quizás se puede mandar a construir una guitarra más chica.
En este caso es un poquito más que
65. Es un poquito más que 65, pero hay guitarras de todos los estilos. Los tiros más habituales son el 65, también es bastante común el tiro de 64, también es bastante común los tiros 66 o 66-4. Son tiros más largos, ¿no? Y se hacen en relación también al tamaño.
And it's worth to mention that Mr. Lozao is a very knowledgeable traditional. This is not just anyone. This guy knows more than the Spanish people here, right? So that's why I'm quoting him, because I want to have a good reference. So this is not that I'm not criticizing him. I just cannot stand with the tradition anymore. It's very boring for me, but you should know that this guy really knows about the traditional thing. So therefore, that's why I use this to quote it. Because in Spain, nobody comes close to this point, what he's saying. Here, you can tell this guy has knowledge. Perhaps only Maestro Romanillos will know. But because he's totally biased towards the Torres ideas, in my opinion, is also blind to the facts of the deficiencies that the so-called traditional design has itself inherent to its obsolescence, right? Because it is obsolete, right? Nobody, I said this is obsolete, and sometimes people freaks out. But if I go and say that the first cell phone is obsolete, nobody says anything. They agree. So why not in the guitar design? Sorry. Why do we have to keep doing the same of the same always? Right? This is what AG is great at. But it's worth to mention that this guy knows what he's saying. So therefore, and of course, in AG we have also guitars, short scale guitars, a lot of them actually, of 610 millimeters, like this, for instance, which is a short scale one, right? And it's like having one fret less. This will be like the first fret will be measurement of the second fret, something like this, right? It's very, very easy to play also. This is, in fact, for very small hands, as he says, so that's true. Okay, let's continue.
Acá también, en la vigencia de algunos métodos, como el método Suzuki, de guitarras más pequeñas para chicos, a veces se hacen tiros de hasta 56 centímetros, tiros más cortitos. En general hay plantillajes, yo acá tengo algunas plantillas que ya tienen marcados los trastes. Entonces cuando viene una persona a ver si su guitarra tiene detectó que tiene problemas de afinación, lo primero que se chequea es, se pone la regla determinada sobre los trastes y ve si el instrumento coincide. Una vez que yo chequeo el tiro de la guitarra, vamos a suponer que puede ser un 65, a ver si es algo parecido a un 65, ahí tendrían que coincidir todos los trastes. Esta guitarra sí, es prácticamente 65. Entonces, acá ya puedo descartar si las limitas que yo tengo de mi regla coinciden con cada traste, quiere decir que la guitarra está bien entrestada para ese tiro.
That is if the bridge is rightly placed, which is also not placed properly in 120% of the cases here in Spain, so careful with this fact.
Que nos excede la explicación en este momento, la distancia del traste 0 al traste 12 en un tiro de 65 es la mitad, 32,5. Del traste 12 al apoyo de la cuerda también matemáticamente tendría que ser 32,5. Por un tema de compensar la presión que el guitarrista ejerce sobre la cuerda, generalmente esta distancia tiene que ser en 1 o 2 milímetros más larga que esta distancia. Entonces esa es la primera cosa que uno te verifica con una regla, la medida. A veces una cejuela mal limada, el apoyo de la cuerda queda para adelante o para atrás en el limado de la cuerda, hace que genera una pequeña desafinación en el traste 12.
Claro, si no es muy redondeado el bolsito,
claro, la
guitarrista puede joder.
Se puede tirar hacia adelante o hacia atrás, ¿no? Entonces, si agarramos otro instrumento, o sea, acá vemos, bueno, en este caso los materiales de las cejas pueden ser diferentes. Habíamos hablado para las simplificaciones, por ejemplo, se usaba el coria, en este caso es un pedazo de coria negro, la cejuela. Bueno, los apoyos están detallados y tienen una medida.
This Korean thing is a plastic thing, and by the way, it's good to mention that in AG there is carbon fiber, and this is the only guitar in the world which has this saddle of carbon fiber.
La guitarra es de 64.8, vamos a redondear el tiro, y acá la distancia, acá sería 32.4. Y acá es 32,55 porque está compensando la distancia. Obviamente que son medidas aproximadas, estas realmente se hacen en el proceso de calibrar la guitarra con un afinador, se ve cuánto más atrás o cuánto más adelante. En las guitarras eléctricas, a veces, esta es una guitarra tipo Stratocaster, los puentecitos son regulables, tienen un tornillo y entonces uno puede tirar el apoyo para adelante o para atrás.
This is a very smart thing, actually, and in fact, the ironical thing here about is that a $100 guitar, electric guitar, tunes well, but a 10,000 Spanish guitar, so-called of big brand name, does not tune because it has problems in the frets, as I showed here. You can test with the business card and just open your eyes if you want to, and if not, good luck. But a guitar that doesn't tune is a garbage. Doesn't matter who made it, who plays it, if Vicente Amigo plays it, or anyone plays it. I don't care. I care about accuracy and perfect tuning. And of this, Mr. Herman Hauser knew what to do, and is the only one that knew what to do on this regard. So, and this was from Germany, this museum. Now, to test all the things that the fretboard may be bent, so to help with that, check these things.
To know if your fretboard is bent, pick the finger one on the first fret, sixth string, and with the pinky finger of the right hand, I will press the last fret, like this. So finger one, and this pinky finger of the last fret. And then here in between, with the thumb, I will control that there is no distance. There can be maybe 1 millimeter of compensation, so in certain models, but as a general guideline, this has to be straight, totally. So finger one, and the pinky here, and now in between, I test with the thumb like this. Just to see that in this point, let me see if I can come closer to show you how straight is this. So I put finger one, and then this finger, and then you can see that this, there is no distance here in between in the string around the 9th fret, right? If this is otherwise bent, then it will be very noticeable, the gap here.
So of course it doesn't tune if it's bent. Now what is action? Let's clear that one more time.
So here we have the black line is the string, the red line is the fretboard, and this blue line is the top. It's the line of the top. So this is the proper settlement. Here, this is the balance here, yes. String, the fretboard, follow a line, and also is aligned with the top settlement. And therefore, this thing, this is the wrong thing. What generally happens is that the string goes here, and then the red line, which represents the fretboard, look how on the 12th fret it goes so high here, the action. This is the right understanding of action, is not to count just from the 12th fret to the string, right? Because here we can say, for example, from here to here. Yeah, that's one thing. But
that's only one.
You also need to check that the fretboard should be aligned with the string, right? And with the top. How's this top basically aligned here? You have this one measurement, which has to correspond with the fretboard and with the string all the way. Of course, here there would be a little bit more distance than, say, on the 5th fret or 7th fret, but not much difference, because it should follow one line, one total line, this thing here, right, this way. And then, therefore, it looks like this. The top aligned with the fretboard and aligned with the string. Otherwise, what is the wrong thing is generally that the string goes like this, and look, the fretboard. The fretboard is on a line, and
yeah,
then now we have the top this way or bent up here. Crazy thing. So this is not balanced, and therefore if you just count about 12th fret distance from the 12th fret to the 6th string, that's just a very primitive way to count the action. This is the wrong way to consider. Action is more than just the distance between the 12th fret and the 6th string. Action means also that it's balanced here. The settlement of the top corresponds to that of the fretboard and that of the string. And then we have the perfect way to understand this action concept, this here, which is perfectly
balanced, right? Yes. While this other is just a mistake because this one is going here like this on the top, then the fretboard is like this, and then the string other way around. So this one is the right one. Okay, so if you ever ask yourself if your guitar tunes well or what is tuning, you know what to do now.
La española es ese tipo de sistema, como que salía mucho, no se utiliza.
Entonces lo que me conviene hacer es ir al taller de luthier con mi guitarra,
verificar que esté,
un poquito,
verificar que esté bien dividido el diapasón, eso lo va a hacer el luthier,
and if not,
y verificar
what?
Que el tiro de la distancia de cuerda sea correcto.
Yo quiero calibrar de manera casera la guitarra.
This is a tricky answer because he's saying it has to be accurate, and if it's not, which is 110% of the time, what? Just check your guitar. I dare you. Check your guitar. Check any guitar you have. And let's see. Because when you put mathematics on the table to argue, then people is very, they shake. Start to shake. Why? Because 2 plus 2 is 4, my friend. It's not 7 or 10. So 2 plus 2, 4, that's all. If it doesn't tune because it's wrong the frets, or it's wrong the bridge, right? Or it has the actual non-balanced of the whole measurements, which these people traditional, they don't know this way of understanding action. I also didn't know it until Paco explained me this thing, right?
Y no puedo ir al luthier, lo puedo hacer.
Sí, en principio podría ser el caso de sí, y si te topas con un problema en el medio de tu propia calibración, bueno, sí, siempre está la posibilidad de ir a aprender. Pero en principio la típica cuestión de reemplazar la secuela o la ceja de allá es un trabajo que si tenés paciencia y prueba y error, puedes conseguir estos en muchas casas de música, se consiguen.
Okay, so here the thing that now he's saying to the girl that she can do it alone. The only advantage, you don't have to see the face of a traditional luthier, but I also learned it because when one is traveling, I don't let my guitar to just anyone if something happens. So small adjustments you need to know how to do, but eventually you don't need to fix it, anything. If you get a guitar like this, with a fretboard like this, you don't need to fix one damn thing in your whole life. Why? Because it's perfect from day one. So this is what we want, right? If we want playability and comfort and high quality of an instrument, you need to get the proper thing.
Me ayudó porque descubrí ahí la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería, cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien. Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular. La música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.